Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. In this episode, we are going to start working on the create, read, update, and delete features of the post. But before we get to that, there's a little modification I want us to make. If we go to our code base and open to the app folder, and then the helpers folder, and then the validate topic and the validate users.php file, inside this file, we are validating to see that to ensure that the user doesn't create a user with an email that already exists. So what we are doing is we are selecting records from the database that has the same email as the one that the user has provided, and we check if that user exists. If it exists, then we're not going to create the user, we're just going to push an error onto the errors array. But here we are using an isSet method to check if a user exists, which is not really very accurate, because the isSet method checks if a variable has been set. In this case, it is always set. It might be set to an empty value, but doesn't change the fact that it is being set. So in some versions of PHP, I have not really tried this, but in some versions of PHP, this might always return true whether or not the user exists. So maybe sometimes, even when you provide a user with an email that doesn't exist in the database, this will always return true and you keep getting this error in your application. Okay, so we're just going to remove the isSet method. Now, if the user exists, this if statement alone will suffice. It will be enough to check if the user actually exists. So I'm going to save this. I go to the validate topic function where we are checking if a topic already exists with the name that the user has provided. I will also remove this isSet function. And when you remove it, ensure that your brackets are balanced. I'm actually making this change in response to a certain comment I got from a viewer who said their topics was always returning this error message whether or not the name existed. So if you came across that error, this might be the solution that works for you. Okay, so that is it for that particular error. So now we can proceed to working on the posts themselves. So the first thing we're going to do is create a post table in our database. This table is going to have about 7 columns. The first one is going to be the ID, which is going to be an integer of length 11, and it will be auto-incrementable. The second is the user ID, which is the ID of the user who created this post. It's going to have a length of 11 too, followed by the title of the post, which is going to be a variable character length, maximum of 255 characters, followed by the image of the post. This is just going to be the name of the image, not the actual image itself. So it's going to be a variable character length, maximum 255. We're also going to have the body of the post, which is the text content for the post. So it'd be of type text, followed by the published column. This is going to be a Boolean field that tells us whether we want the post to be visible on the public section or not. So we select tinyInt for the type, because tinyInt is the same as Boolean. Finally, we have the createdAt column, and this is going to be the date time, which is the time that the post was created, and it will have a default value of the current timestamp. So that is it with our post table. We can click on the save button and our post table is ready to go. So now we can start writing the code on how to create posts. So let's go back to our source code. And we have already implemented the feature to create, read, update, and delete topics. Now we are moving into the post folder to do the same. And this is going to be very similar to what we did in the topics folder. So I'm just going to do a lot of copying and pasting just to save us some time. So the first thing we'll do is we'll go to the create.php file. Now, if you open the create.php for topics, you are going to notice a few things. First of all, we are bringing in the controllers file that is going to hold receive the form values. Let's do the same in the create.php for the post inside the post folder. So up here, we are going to create a file inside the controllers folder called posts, and this is where we are going to handle our form submission when the user is creating a post. So let's create that file now. So inside the controllers folder, in the app folder, we create a new file called post.php. Now this file is similar to the topics.php in the same folder. So here we are also going to need two files in our post.php, just like we did in the topics.php file. So here we are going to bring in the db.php file for database queries, and then we're also going to have a file called validate posts to validate our posts. And of course, we are going to create this file right now inside the helpers folder. So inside the same app folder, and then inside the helpers folder, we'll create a new file called validateposts.php. You know what, because I am using the singular form for these other ones, I'm just going to keep this one in singular format just to be consistent. And of course, I will also make sure that here I'm including validate post without an S. So okay, most of the things have been set up. We can now start submitting our form and receiving the form values in our post.php file. So let's scroll down to our form and make the necessary arrangements before we submit it. Now this is going to be submitted to the same page, create.php, and we're going to give our submit button a name of add post. Okay, so when this button is clicked, it will be submitted to the same page, and because we have included post.php in the same page, we will have access to it here. So we are going to check if the user has clicked on the post button, on the add post button. And if they have done that, the first thing we are going to do for now is just to display the contents of the form that they have submitted, just to be sure that we are receiving the values here. So on our browser, we are going to navigate to admin folder and then posts, and then create.php, and here we have our add post form. I'm just going to create a test form. Let's just choose a random image, and when we click on add post, it is going to bring those values here. Okay, so that's good. Now we have established one fact: our form is submitting. Okay, so another thing I want us to do is, if you notice, as we were creating our post on the form, our topics dropdown still has only one topic on it. And in some tutorial in the past, we had created a lot of topics in our topics table, which means that we need to start loading these topics from the database so that we have all the available topics under which a user can create a post. So what we are going to do is, we are going to query the topics table. We'll select all topics into the variable called topics. And this file has been included in our create.php, so we can come here. This is the field in which we display our topics. So here we are going to loop through the topics array, the topics array that we just fetched from the database. So we use a for each loop. For each topic, we are going to display an option in the dropdown. And the value of the option is, this is going to be an echo where we'll print out the name of the topic. That is the value. And the thing that the user actually sees is also going to be the value, sorry, the name. Okay, so this is it. If we go back to our browser and refresh, and then we click on the drop down, we see now that it is now fetching all our topics from the database. Okay, I'm just going to make this one empty because initially we just want it to be empty. Okay, all right, so this is it for selecting the topics on the form, and now we can start working on the actual create post. Actually, before we get to that, there is one change I want us to make on the create form. Actually, the select input field is supposed to have a name of topic ID, because we are going to need the ID of the topic in order to establish the relationship between the post and the topic. And on the option input field, the value attribute should be set to the ID of the topic and not the name, because what we need for the relationship between post and topic is the ID of the topic. But as for the name, we are going to leave it here because this is what gets displayed for the user to read and understand. Okay, so having made these changes, we can now try it out. Let's try to create a new post. We select a topic and click add post, and now it adds the topic ID and as well as the other fields. Now the first thing we want to do is we want to match the field to the columns. So we are going to remove the fields, the columns that do not belong to our post table in the database. So for now, we'll remove the topic ID and the add post columns from this our post data before we create our post. So in PHP, the way we do that is with an onSet method, and then we specify the particular fields we want to onSet. In this case, we are onSetting the add post field and the topic ID field. Again, this topic ID, we are only onSetting it for now. Very soon, when we are establishing the relationship, we are going to need it. So if we go back to this form and refresh, we are going to see that those fields no longer exist because we have onSet them. So we have title, body, image, title, image, body, but we don't yet have user ID and published. We don't need to set the created at because it will be saved automatically. So the only two we need to add now is the published and the user ID. The user ID is the ID of the currently logged in user, and for now we're just going to hard code it for the moment. So we'll just give its value to 1, and then as for the published, we'll also give the value of 1. Remember, the published field is a tiny int, which either takes 1 for true or 0 for false. So we want it to be published, so we're going to set it to 1. Now we save this and then refresh again and resubmit the form, and it has added these values. So now we have everything in place, and so we can call the create method. So here we will do post, we'll call the create method we defined inside our db.php file. This method is going to take as first argument the name of the table, in this case posts, and as second argument the data that will be used to create the post. Now we can extract this variable to a variable called table, and make sure we define that table variable outside here. And then very soon we'll be doing validation, and we need an errors array to hold the validation error messages. So let's just initialize these two variables here for now. And if you go to our browser, I think we can create a post right now. Let's refresh our table to verify that there is no post. And then let's also remove this print statement, this display statement, so that it can allow, not remove it actually, let's display the post that gets created. Sorry, the ID of the post that gets created. And that is because the create method returns the ID of the post of any record that it creates. So back on our browser, we refresh, it returns 1, which means our post has been created. Alright, so that's cool. So normally, after the user creates a post, what we want to do is redirect them to the manage posts page. So I'm just going to use the base URL variable we defined, and then it will take us to the home page. So we enter the admin folder, posts, and then index.php, because this is the file in which we manage posts. And of course, just like we did in the create.php file, including, that is to include this post controller, we're going to do the same inside the index.php. We include the post. Okay, now inside this controller, we have to select the post that we want to display on this manage post page. So we are going to do something similar like we did on the topics. So in this case, it's going to be called, sorry, post. And of course, you are going to call the posts table. And because we are calling this variable, we need to put it on top so that it doesn't say undefined. As for the topics, we can just leave it here, because inside this file, we'll probably call topics only once. The reason I'm putting the table in a variable is because we are going to call it multiple times in this file. So make sure you move the table variable on top before you reference it in the select all. Now the array of posts from the database are now available inside our manage posts page. So if you go to the browser, you can have a look at our manage posts page. The data you see here is only the data you see here is static, so we are going to remove it, and then we will loop through what we got from the database. And for each record, we are going to display a row. Okay, so the first thing we are going to do is we'll display the key. The key here starts from 0, 1, 2, and so on. So we are going to display that key plus 1 so that it starts counting from 1. And then the next thing is we're going to display the title. And of course, we'll pull that from the post variable. As for the username, this username is going to come from the users table. For now, in the post that we created, we have only the user ID. We will use it to fetch the username of that particular user. But for now, let's just leave it here. We are going to change it later because we are not yet working on the relationship. Okay, as for the published, we are going to do an if statement. So if the post is published, then we are going to display an unpublished method. Sorry, an unpublished link. And we give it a class of unpublished. And then if the post is not published, we will display the publish link, so that the user can click on it and publish it. There seems to be a mistake somewhere, and that is we need to change this to colons. Sorry, just the one. Oh, this one is semicolon. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so this is it. Now let's go back to our browser and refresh, and it brings our record. And because we have already published the article, we can click on this button to unpublish it. So let's go back to our post once again and create another post. We choose a file. Of course, we have not yet implemented our image upload. We'll do that in some other episode. When we click on add post, it creates the post. So we have implemented create and read for our post. Of course, there are a few other things such as validation and image upload, which we haven't yet done on the create feature. And we're going to do that probably in the next episode. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next episode.